at that and send him deep off stage. As I lied to y'all, because we're not even gonna see the Kazuya, I'm upset. We're gonna be seeing Zelda and Bowser. Okay, so actually we're playing Wi-Fi.
Playing Wi-Fi. I was so ready for Kazuya. Let's go.
I'm mad. I'm mad as hell. I watched y'all to lose game one because I was hyping up the Kazuya. But nah, for real though, Zelda is one of those characters that does benefit from being in a double situation because you could use Nehru's Love as a combo breaker a bit easier. And it's also easy to set up Phantom sometimes for when they're trying to jump somebody. Bowser, on the other hand, good in many regards, hates being 2v1'd. Yeah. So it's going to be pretty hard for Tall to actually find a landing, like So, who landed directly in front of the frying pan.
Yo, combo food, like, this dude, his main ingredient is being comboed. It's so bad. But it's all right, though. Bowser can put in some work.
Yeah, I mean, one good thing that does work for Bowser is, in fact, that flying slam. That side B will hit other teammates. And also, like, he has the ability to burst quicker than people remember because his run speed is stupid. But Zelda, not the best character in terms of combo breaking outside of using maybe Jin's fire. So I'm curious to see what the blue team's answer is going to be when they're getting team combo, because so far we haven't really seen one outside of when Bowser runs in and forward airs.
Yeah, right now blue team is not really holding on to anything, any type of advantage. Like, Bowser's being consistently bullied either by like Peach or a straight hit from Luigi or anything.
I mean,
but he gets that kill though.
Yeah, one thing that Bowser does not lack is kill power, and if you find a sweet spot, same with Zelda. So
I'm actually super surprised. This is kind of even still favor is in red team. But right now, red team is literally holding on and doing a ton of work here. And look, oh my god.
Oh, I mean, hey, look, find the opportunities where you can. But that's going to be up smash. You jump directly above Link and you recognize that you weren't really in a good spot to jump towards Scott. Gets the up smash. Run away from that. Don't try to challenge that. That side B will beat you every time.
I got to give it to blue team. Even though, like, they're struggling, they are always aware and ready to help their teammate when they're in disadvantage or for even, like, a setup for a kill.
Yeah, I think we're definitely seeing, like, what is probably another static. Like, they definitely look like they are unaware, like you said, of, oh, we got the ledge trap. I'm going to go off stage to try to help you. Or, actually, that was a really good job holding down on the up B there to push Ling off stage. Now Ling is actually kind of having a hard time getting back. But when you leave Bowser alone with Mario, Luigi, usually bad things happen.
Yeah, I didn't even see where Bowser went. Bowser's a big body. He just disappeared. But he's back now with the share stock.
And good DI from Ling multiple times at that time, avoiding the up B. Not going to get the kill. Tries to get back on, but Bowser finds the hit. So this is still looking pretty rough for blue team. But I think in the future games, how many pummels were you allowed to get? All right, hold up.
He was not mashing.
Dude, mash. Mash, please. It'll help you. Trust me. Oh.
What?
Was that a misfire?
Yeah, it was a misfire.
Well.
Yo, this is over. This is over.
Yeah, well, So Oni-chan is currently it's going to be so hard for Bowser to land. Like,
yeah.
There you go, gets the grab. Misses on the forward smash, but the frame trap is, like, pretty much still there. Like, now you got to recover high, you're dead.
It was nothing he can do as a character. As a character, man.
Your kit is limited to so many options, especially when recovering. Like, trying to get around one person is hard enough. Two bodies, where you got a plunger coming down, turnip coming down, possibly fireballs to force you low. There's so much that goes in favor of the red team there in terms of forcing Bowser into a bad spot. I wonder if maybe the wide stage might have been a detriment to them because Flying Slam could be a bit more viable on a smaller stage where you want to be more chaotic and possibly hit Scott or Ling for falling asleep.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead,
I didn't mean to cut you off, but like, just like the, even though they're playing down, even though they're losing for the most part, like they are just so in tune to each other's like needs. Like, gets grabbed, boom.
Yeah.
He would have died for a back throw, but like still, like you got the grab, you instantly jumped over and it's hit. Like, I love that. Even though you're playing, even though you're like,
Even though he unfortunately hit his teammate there, he had the right idea. It's like, oh, I see you're in danger. I'm going to go help. We saw earlier where they almost got that early kill on Ling, where he's at like 20 when they tried to go for the ledge trap.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they understand what they need to do.
Uh-oh, your favorite character's on the screen.
Oh. Oh, yeah, I forgot. He also said he used to play this. Bruh, how are you going to let me give you the best promo of the night with the Kazuya, and then you play Bowser in Game & Watch? I'm done with you. But as we get here into game number two with Smashville, you know, actually I was expecting Smashville as a pick for the Bowser. This is still an incredibly good stage for Game & Watch, but there's two bodies, so up being around or trying to go for nair pressure on the platform isn't going to be as good. I think maybe they're looking for ledge traps and trying not to fight the red team as much.
So blue team is putting in work right now. They actually have the lead. And just that setup that was happening there when that holding jab was happening, and then Game & Watch just jumped around and did back air for like shield pressure to hopefully break the shield.
Yeah.
I like the way this team is thinking.
I mean, we just saw a second ago, too. Like, they were perfectly lined up for that forward throw to up air. They get the first kill on board. They get almost the second kill on board. So Misfire is going to get you back in, but so far, Blue Team is actually looking really good here with the switch to Game & Watch. Almost setting himself up for an unfortunate team kill that would have led off of that nair into the Luigi Cyclone.
Red team fighting back, clawing back in there, but blue team still looking nice. And
not dying to dash attack, so either. Even with 133% on rage, holding down on the up B again as well to make sure it hits above the ledge, catching Scott slipping at the ledge.
Like, what DI does Tal have? Oh, never mind, he's dead though. I want to say, like, he was living for so long.
We were talking about it, stock longevity, right? This man was staying alive for that damn long, so well played. All right, here we go, though, looking for like a Cyclone at the ledge, trying to maybe keep Onichan from coming in, but also just trying to catch Tal slipping above the ledge. Got invincibility frames there.
So Onichan is from CT, right?
Yes.
Okay.
West side.
West side of CT. Mm-hmm. Do they play, when I say they, does Ling Ling and Onichan play often?
I don't know, but it definitely, I think they might have, because it definitely looks like Onichan is understanding of Ling's consistent ledge traps and his love for downer on shield. But you can't really do that against Game & Watch very easy. This is one of the more annoying matchups for Peach is Game & Watch. Like, anybody who has good counter float game is going to be a struggle. But, missed the upbeat. That definitely would have been a kill.
So. And shout out to Red Team. I mean, they're not the only smart team synergy doing cool stuff and covering their opponent.
Yeah.
That upbeat miss on, Luigi. He landed, about to get punished crazy, and Ling was like, yo, hold up.
Yeah, Tal just missed a good edge guard a second ago, too. Like, a big difference, definitely in this game at least, is not just the Onichan switch to Game & Watch, but the play from Tal Zelda has been much better as they could once again get another lead. They get a two stock lead again. That is an answer from Ling, but I like what Onichan's doing. I'm gonna hide off stage. I'm gonna let Tal with invincibility from the platform get in front of me so I can get back on stage for free.
I think this is Blue Team's game.
Yeah, I think this is Blue Team's game to lose. Like, they definitely can still lose this, but the way that they started things off, I think that this is their game to lose here.
This is their game to lose? Blue Team's going to lose this game?
No, like, they have to, like, basically they have to throw it. Like, I think they've been playing well here in this game that, like, Red Team, with it, like, they haven't had the same combos that they had. They haven't had the same positional awareness, but we are at one stock apiece. Yeah. This is where pressure starts to line up. Yeah. It's like, okay, all that good early, like, gameplay we had is now on last stock. We cannot throw this game.
Yeah, you never know, man. Someone can make a mistake. You can just, like, flub. Someone can do an amazing combo or an amazing read.
Yeah, or you could get an accidental team hit, too, that forced Ling off stage. Bacon, it's so good.
Yo, Bacon's dope. Bacon's dope.
Neutral B. Oh, and the off-smash read on the get-up from Scott is now going to put the blue team back in the lead. Ling is excellent at 2v1s, but I don't know how well he's going to do here when you got potential neighbors up or Nair pushing him deep off stage. You got to worry about the neutral B from Game & Watch.
I think Game & Watch should probably fight Ling more because like Zelda is about to die. Like,
yeah, you see Ling looking for it. He's trying to find that forward air on Zelda really bad right now. It's not going to be super easy either because Game & Watch is very annoying for Peach.
Yo, all right, Zelda, stay away from Ling. Seriously. There we go. Not going to kill
them. Still not going to die just yet. That back air coming in, but I mean, one straight hit, yeah, there you go. Chair went,
with the
chair
steel
kills
chair
every time.
Yeah.
Options were covered very well there too, because you had Tal at roll position again. That like if you're a struggling doubles team on the come up, make sure that you work on your ledge trap position, especially in 2v1s, because 2v1s are where a lot of teams can falter. You get too aggressive, you run in too much, and you get hit a lot, and then all of a sudden you drop a 2v1, and then you're both pissed at each other after. But when you look at the way that these teams have positioning for covering neutral getup, covering getup attack, and then covering roll, if they jump, then you can pressure them after they jump into center stage because you have two people in between them. Sometimes you don't need to overcommit, but it was very crucial in the way that blue team played this game that they had good ledge position and they had a lot of good edge guards too. I really like the way they switched that up here in game two.
That was just really good, I feel, adjustment, honestly, just all Nichan's part. Yeah. Like, I think everyone's playing pretty much the same, but just that element of that
you
game.
You see, and you saw at the end there, you saw exactly where they stood. Yeah. Neutral getup was covered by chair.
Yep.
If you get hit by getup attack and you knock Game & Watch out of the way, dash attack comes in from Zelda, you rinse, repeat. Now here on to PS2 for game number two. No character switches. They realized Game Watch is definitely the better pick in here and in this matchup.
Yeah, bigger stage at the same time as well. So I wonder if just like having that much more space to kind of like deal with or make it harder for them both to kind of cover each other. That might be another play as well, because their synergy, honestly, I feel like they're just evenly matched.
I mean,
it's
I think
so good.
One of the things that's, in game one we recognize is that red team thrives more when they have more space. Blue team definitely played a lot better there on Smashville because they had the ability to kind of scramble a bit, and it made not only Zelda's buttons more alive, but unfortunately, Zelda's fair ended up getting the team kill there on the Game Watch. So that's not what you want to see at the start.
But that's right, still not out of the game. We got high percent on both red team players, and actually, hold up. Blue team lost their second stock.
My man died at 88% dealt to that up air. That up air is so damn strong. So that was huge for the blue team to get that kill. Scott's got to be careful with being at the ledge. That turf actually came in clutch because pretty much the only thing he was able to do was go for an up B there. Yep, 100%. As soon as Ling has that set up, that's guaranteed for the up B to get that hit. He died at 68 because of that.
Yeah, I feel so bad for blue team because I was Zelda. Like, I ran up and I was like, wait, what do I do? Like, how do I stop this without dying myself?
I can't really do anything. Like, if I dash attack, I might accidentally get hit too.
Yeah.
So, that's it. But you know what? Good mental awareness on the red team. And at the start, this is much more even. But because of that, like, nice early kill, they have a half decent lead here, especially because Zelda's at 104.
I mean, I feel like this game is going to go for red team. That first team kill really kind of set it up and just forced that momentum in their favor. But red team, with that stage, man,
dude,
you might be right. That stage, just having that much space to just kind of do what you want to do might be the key to their victory.
Yeah, wide stage is the win con. They have played so much better. There you go again. Because Zelda's burst range is not very good. Zelda's very committal on what she has to do. Game & Watch is also kind of clunky in the way that he approaches too. He needs one character. And now they're down to four stocks. Ling fooling around on the ledge. Like, he's trying to look for something big here. Gets the turn up, looking for the forward air. Can't find the mark, though.
Yeah, this is just going to be a halfway of a clip 2v1 combo, but yeah, I like this fight back though.
Yeah, if that nair. He tried to find the disrespectful taunt to get the spike at the ledge. I'm here for it. I love it. Oh, but hold on though.
Ooh.
All right, everybody wanted to get a piece. Ling looking for Luigi as well.
And Naru's love for that movement to get away from Peach, man. That was just dope.
I like what's... Oh!
What was that?
Eat your veggies. That was...
Was that Dot Eyes?
I don't think it was Dot Eyes. I think it might have been Winky Face, but it was enough knockback to end the set, and that was only a best of three here in Losers Top 8. That was...
Top 6, actually.
Yes. So that is going to be... The red team moving on.
Oh, that was the regular face, like the two lines on the eyes and the circle or dot for the.
Yeah, he was just so deep into the blast zone. You can see like his animation was still stuck, so he was in a lot of hit stun there.
Oh boy.
And just couldn't recover. Even if he did, Scott was right there at the edge, so he had to watch out for that. And then Ling was going to get himself back into like on the platform because Peach is one of a few characters that could cover roll and jump very easy. But we're going to be moving into what I believe is Loser Semis because I see that Ling and Scott haven't moved. So I'm assuming this is Loser Semis of